بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Today, inshallah, we are going to start our third lesson on Tajweed al-Quran. Today, inshallah, we will be discussing about the different types of mistakes. And as you can see on the screen, there are two types of mistakes. The first type of mistake is major mistakes. This is called lahnul jali in Arabic. Lahnul jali is a combined phrase. The lahnul means error or mistake, and jali means clear, serious, or major. So all those mistakes that changes the meaning of the Holy Quran, they are classified as major mistakes. And the second type of mistakes are minor mistakes. They are in Arabic al-lahnul khafi, or the small mistakes, minor mistakes. So major mistakes are and the ruling about the major mistake is it is haram to recite the Quran with lahne jali. So by committing a lahne jali mistake, the meaning of that verse where the lahne jali or the major mistake is committed may become very badly distorted. So as we know that the Quran is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, divine words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when someone recites Quran, as he speaks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he does not pronounce the letters and words of the Quran, that means he changes the meaning. And when he changes the meaning, he is not changing meaning of the creation, he is changing the meaning of the Creator's words, which is a very, very serious thing. So this is why the scholar says the major mistakes are haram. Haram means completely forbidden, because it changes the meaning of the Holy Quran or the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the examples of major mistakes are to replace a letter with another letter, or the second category of major mistakes are to replace a haraka with a sukun, or a sukun with a haraka. So a haraka means zair zabar pesh, or zumma fatha kasra, and sukun means a combining or joining symbol. And when a haraka is replaced by a sukun, or a sukun replaced by a haraka, then it is a major mistake. Also, the third category of major mistake is to replace a haraka with another haraka. That means to change a zer zabar pesh with another zer zabar pesh. It means that where there is a zumma, if someone read in place of zumma, instead of zumma, if he reads the fatha, then it is also a major mistake. So the examples, the Arabic examples from the Quran of the major mistakes are kalbun. So kalbun means dog. If someone, instead of saying kalbun, if he says olbun, then change the meaning, because kalbun means heart and kalbun means dog. So where if the in the Quran, if the, in any verse, if any in any verse the word is kalbun, if someone says kalbun, that means he is replacing a word with another word. Or if he says the other way around, where the word is kalbun, if he says with a small kaf, or which is lightly pronounced, if he says that kalbun, that means also it changes the meaning. So another example is like replace a letter with another letter, which is alimun. Alimun sounds like another word, alimun. So alimun and alimun, what is the difference? Different is the first letter in the first word is Hamza, and the first letter of the second word is Ayn. And if someone does not pronounce Hamza, he pronounces Ayn instead of Hamza, then it is also replacing the letter with another letter. And in that case, it also changes the meaning. Because Aleem means a painful punishment, and Aleem with Ayn, it means all knowing. So Aleem is one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Aleem is something about a punishment which will be given or applied to the disbelievers in the hell. So Ayn and Hamza, two letters sound similar, but there is a criteria to differentiate and separate the both between the both pronunciation, and for that the learners need to learn the makharij or tajweed. So when someone is familiar with this sound, different sound of different letters, then they will understand the difference between the letters and how to pronounce them properly. And also you can say, you can see the another examples on the screen. Wattin. Wattin and Wattin. There's two examples and they sound nearly same. Wattin means fig fruit. Wattin, the word starts with a ta. And the Wattin, the second word starts with tho, letter tho. The first letter starts with a ta, which is a empty mouth letter, and the second letter starts with tho, which is full mouth letter. So instead of if the word of the Quran is teen, and if someone says Wattin with full mouth letter, then it will be also haram and forbidden, because he is replacing a letter with a letter. Because teen is different, and teen with full mouth letter tho, it is different, because they have completely different meaning. So this is why it's very, very important to be careful when read Quran, and very careful about pronouncing the letters, because sometimes if we replace the letters with another letter, then it will change the meaning, and when it changes the meaning, then we will commit the haram or major sin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand and act upon it. Inshallah, tomorrow inshallah, we will talk about the second examples of major mistakes, which is to replace a haraka with a sukoon or sukoon with a haraka. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.